Well, hello, everybody. Today's coffee break is on creating and maintaining budgets. As the year end approaches, this is usually when we start getting questions about, creating your budgets. And there are really three ways that you can create a budget. One is you can do it manually. You can just key the whole thing in. Or you can export it from Navision to Excel, edit it, and import it back into Navision, which is my favorite. And you can also copy GL totals from a previous year to create your budget. So let me go ahead and show you those. Let's go to Departments, Financial Management, General Ledger, and here we have our GL budgets. All right, I've already got one in here. Let's see. I'll pull this up. Now, when you come into the budgets, you can determine how you want to see things, if you want to see it by day, by period, by week. I'm going to go by month here. And so you'll see now my column headings have changed. And if we wanted to, I want to filter on just my expense accounts. So I believe that should do the trick. Okay. And as I mentioned, one of the ways that you can enter your budget is just by manually keying it in. So let's go down. All right. And you could just, and I realize these are not realistic numbers. It would be nice if they were. But you can manually key them in if you know them. And you would just go through, and as you're keying in numbers, you'll see that your totals are totaling, and it functions the same way that your chart of accounts does. There we go. You see, so when your totals come up, you can drill into the totals and see where those numbers came from, and they're from other areas of the budget. Again, works just like your current chart of accounts. So that's one method of creating a budget. The other would be to export it from Navision to Excel, edit it there, and bring it back in. So what a lot of people do is they will actually send this out to different departments. They'll enter it in Excel, and then someone will put that data together and import it back into Navision. So from here, I'm just going to go to Export to Excel. My date, 12 periods. My period length is, 1 month. And I'm just going to click OK. And it's going to create that Excel spreadsheet. And it's nice. It puts in all the titles. It puts in the totaling. And it makes it easy to use. So what would happen at this point is someone would just come in here. And they would go in, like I said, and put in their numbers, make their changes, add their numbers, whatever needs to be done. And once they're finished, you can save it. Let's see here. I'll throw it on my desktop so I can find it again. There we go. And then you can come back into the budget and import from Excel. Now, when you did the import, you have a couple choices here. You choose, of course, the budget name that you're importing it into. Because I'm currently in 2016, it populated that information for me. The options I have would be to replace the existing entries or add entries. I'm going to go ahead and replace the existing entries because maybe they took something away. And then you can, of course, put a description in here, imported from Excel. And I'm just going to pop in here. Are you sure you want to replace your entries? I'm going to say yes. Right. And that's it. It replaced my entries. So that's one way to do it. In fact, that's probably what I see used most commonly. There is another method where you can copy a budget from the general ledger. So I can say here that my source is the general ledger. And again, I would put in the range of GL accounts that I'm copying. I would put in the date range that I'm copying. All right. And of course, if you're using dimensions, you would select them as well. enter my budget name here that I'm copying it to. Okay. Now, what I really want to point out here is the adjustment factor. So right now, the adjustment factor defaults to 1, which means it would copy in exactly what we had in the GL last year. But what I want to do is I'm budgeting. So let's say that I have a 10% budget increase. I can actually change that adjustment factor to increase or decrease the budget from our actuals from last year. All right, and I'm going to round it to the nearest tens. And my change date formula would be, let's see, 1 year. Okay. My date compression, let's just do, we'll get our big numbers for each period. Okay. So now what it does is it copies those numbers into this budget. You might want to create revisions. So let's say that you've already got a 2016 budget and it's been revised. Maybe you use that copy function where you copied it from the GL and you want to make some tweaks, but you don't want to lose sight of that original budget. Well, you can have as many budgets as you want. So in this case, I could actually create a new budget and we'll call it 2016 revision 1. And then I can actually use that copy function and I could copy another budget. And maybe I want to, you know, put my adjustment factor in there. All right, so that is a common question about how many budgets can you have. Many systems limit the number of budgets you can have. Let me remove this filter down here. No date filters. Yeah, they limit the amount of the number of budgets that you can have. Navision is not like that. And people really like to keep track of the different iterations they've gone through. They don't want to lose sight of, where basically the genesis of the budget. This is what it was originally. This is what was changed. So you'll see many revisions. So that's one of the nice features in here. And the copy document helps you do that as well. All right, that concludes our lesson on creating budgets in Navision. Thanks for joining the Copy Break.
Thanks for watching this ArcherPoint video. If you found it helpful, make sure to check out our website and blog at www.archerpoint.com. Additionally, if you have any questions regarding our products, services, or information in this video, feel free to email us at info@archerpoint.com. Thanks.